Hello everyone, welcome back. Flux 0.1 got a new update. This time we can do image to image. So just to put it in perspective, Flux 0.1, the model, when it was released, it got a day one support inside of ComfyUI. And now less than 48 hours, we have image to image. So these technologies are moving really fast. And I apologize if it feels like I'm spamming videos. Now, if you're not sure what I'm talking about, I released a video here exploring Flux 0.1 Schnell. So you can go and watch that video. I explain what is the model. I also show you how you can install it locally inside ComfyUI. I explain the workflow as well. In today's video, we are going to explore the image to image capability of this new model. So here's the workflow. As always, I'm going to link in the description below. And you can see a little bit what is happening. We have an image input. It goes through an image to image workflow, and out we have a variation of that image. Of course, we have a denoising factor, which will determine how much you want to change that image. So quickly, let's go through the workflow. In this particular case, I am using the Schnell model and using FP8. So the dual clip loader as well is using the FP8. And of course, we need the clip L in there. The VAE is the same AE. The only thing that is new here is that we have a load image node. It's going through a VAE encode. This should be familiar by now, especially if you've done image to image inside of ComfyUI, whether you've used SD 1.5, 2.0, 2.1, SDXL, everything should be the same. Now, this VA encode will output a latent, and this latent is going inside the sampler custom advanced as the latent image. And that's it. That's all that's happening. Now, in the basic scheduler, there is a denoising factor. Right now, I have it as 0.75, and the number of steps is 4. And I would say it's not great, simply because at 0.75, if you're using the traditional SD 1.5 or SDXL, you would see a lot more transformation, especially considering that I'm trying to go from a realistic image to an anime style image, and it changed the image but barely. And that is because the Schnell model can go from 1 to 4 steps, so there's very few steps count in between for it to change the input image. Now I'm going to show you a screenshot of another workflow, and here it is. And this workflow was created by Camenduru, and right now they are using the dev model, and the dev model is basically like the full model, and you can increase the number of steps. So in this particular case, we can see that the number of steps is 20, and they are also using the same text prompt. It's anime style. We have a realistic input image, and out comes an anime style of the input image. So not a lot to talk about, but it's great that we got an update, especially less than 48 hours. I cannot wait to see what other updates that we are going to get. I hope that we also get support for the other things like control net or IP adapter and so on. All right, it's a short video, I know, but I wanted to bring your attention to it. Hopefully you can take this and start experimenting with it. By the way, in case you're wondering, the text to image workflow for the Flux 0.1 Schnell model took around 11 minutes. Let's just say 10 minutes on average. But this one, the image to image, is more than double the amount of time. Now, this test that I've done is the Schnell, so I've gone only up to 4 steps. But if I had to go until 20, it would take me longer to generate an image. So the system requirements is quite high. And in the last video, the exploring Flux 0.1, there were some comments saying that even with 64 gigabytes, they were not able to run the FP16. So let me know what is your experience with it, and if there are any other updates, I will keep you posted. Until then, have a nice day. I will see you in the next one.